it's been a professional debate and a spirited debate, and it's been fun to watch and fun to be a part of this process. I wanted to end, and again, this has been a pretty positive debate, but I kind of want to end on something positive. And just bear with me here. As a nation, we're probably more politically polarized than we've been in a long, long time. Approval rating for Congress is less than 10%. We've got negative ads filling our television screens. There is a lot of common ground here, though, as we pointed out earlier with some of the Inquirer statistics. And I want to know, if your opponent was a keynote speaker at an event and you were introducing your opponent, and you had to say something positive, I'm going to give you a minute, and I hope that you can fill that time. And I'm going to start with Roxanne.
I think I could actually fill that time for a minute, because I think that, you know, one of the purposes of political campaigns is to try to highlight the differences so that people can make a choice. But one of the things I have learned in all of my years in office is that people don't choose to run for office because they're bad people, because of all of the negative things that people assume. People choose to run because they want to serve. And John, I believe, is someone who does want to serve. And he wants to serve this community. He, you know, loves this community. He believes in this community. I have always, and I think that when John and I served on council, I remember even giving him a book, which he actually did read, and that was a book of Robert Moses. It was important because it talked about how do you go about, now Robert Moses you have to take with a grain of salt, so just like, well, let me caution you, you know, good things and bad things, but it was about building a city and building a future, and I have never had any doubt whatsoever in my mind that fundamentally John is committed to the city of Cincinnati, he loves the city of Cincinnati, and he is a smart, talented man.
And John, the last positive word of this debate goes to you.
Thank you. I also have a lot of nice things to say about Roxanne. Frankly, I had a wonderful time serving with her on city council, and I respect immensely that she's given the balance of her career to the public. In fact, I met her 21 years ago, I believe it was, at St. Xavier High School, where she was a guest speaker in my history class as a city council person. I didn't mean that. I meant that, like, it's true. I'm not trying to make a joke. And I remember her talking, and I grew up in Price Hill, and I remember her talking about dealing with environmental injustice issues in Lower Price Hill. I remember this very clearly. And if you look at her commitment to the environment, look at her current work to deal with homelessness, very admirable things. And, you know, there's no question in my mind that she is doing what she believes is right, and it was a pleasure serving with her. And I respect deeply that she has given most of her life to public service.
Thank you very much for playing along with that. I appreciate it. Thank you. Sadly, that's all the time we have for this final debate. Half an hour on the television side, half an hour on the internet side. I want to remind folks that we will have much more on our news at 5 o'clock to 6:30 on WLWT News 5. I want to thank our partners today, the Cincinnati Inquirer once again, the Rotary, these folks have been great, and the Cincinnati Business Courier. Also, just selfishly, I'd like to thank Bill Hager, managing editor at WLWT, for helping prepare as well. 12 days until Election Day, very powerful civic duty. Get out and take advantage of it. Thanks again.